cholinergic receptors. Cholinergic receptors are two types, muscarinic receptors and nicotinic receptors. So, on the muscarinic receptors, we have the drugs acting like agonists and antagonists. Muscarinic agonists. So, we have the drugs like acetylcholine. Acetylcholine is not useful as a drug because of its metabolism in the body. But we have other drugs like pilocarpine, carbachol and Bethanechol. These are used as the cholinergic agonists or muscarinic agonists. So, acetylcholine is easily hydrolyzed by acetylcholine esterase enzyme, but whereas drugs like Bethanechol are resistant to the hydrolysis by acetylcholine esterase enzyme. So, these are used in the different clinical settings. Carbachol, Bethanechol and Pilocarpine. These are the three muscarinic agonists, and let us see their uses. Carbachol is used in the treatment of the glaucoma, whereas Bethanechol is going to be used in the urinary retention. Bethanechol is going to increase the bladder contraction, thereby any condition like urinary retention can be prevented. So urination is going to increase by Bethanechol. Bethanechol is also used in the conditions like GI hypotonia, where the intestinal smooth muscle is not contracting. Then Bethanechol can increase the contraction of the GI smooth muscle. And Pilocarpine is one of the best drug used in the treatment of the glaucoma. One of the important thing about the Pilocarpine is it can be used in the emergency treatment of glaucoma, as well as this is one of the drug which can be used in the both open angular as well as closed angular glaucoma. So Pilocarpine is a natural substance which is acting like a muscarinic agonist. So these are the three important muscarinic agonists along with their clinical uses. Now let us go for the muscarinic antagonist. So drugs like atropine and dicyclomine, they are mainly used as the antispasmodics. And similarly, drugs like cyclopentolate and tropicamide, they are used as the midriatics, which produce the pupillary dilatation. And ipratropium and tiotropium, they are selective for the lungs and they produce the bronchodilatation. So they are used as bronchodilators, particularly in the treatment of COPD, chronic obstructive pulmonary disorder. And drugs like tolterodine and oxybutynin are the drugs which are acting like bladder relaxants. And hyoscine, which is also called as scopalamine, is used in the treatment of motion sickness as an antiemetic. And selective muscarinic antagonists, which are acting selectively on the M1, M2, M3 receptors. M1 blocker is the pyrangipine, which is used as an anti-ulcer agent. M2 blocker is the galamine. Of course, galamine is not a pure M2 antagonist. It is also having an additional action like a neuromuscular blocker. And M3 blocker is the darifinacin. So darifinacin is again a bladder relaxant and it is selectively blocking the M3 receptors. So these are the selective muscarinic antagonists acting on the M1, M2 and M3 receptors.